All right, well, we've been talking about Toys for Tots lately, you know, and Albertsons and the Marine Corps and how everybody's really pitched in, and ABC4's really tried to get people to donate toys to Clear Channel, and so it goes to Toys for Tots. Well, one group has really gone above and beyond.
Oh, boy.
Wow. You hear the Star Wars music. Wow. Come on up here, you guys. They are straight from the movie set, it seems like. And you know what? Somebody pointed out, these are all the bad guys.
Yeah,
but
what's up with that?
They aren't that bad when they've donated kids.
And Sergeant Bird's here as well.
Right? I know.
And then we have the spokes trooper right here.
Okay.
Right? Are you the spokes trooper? There we go. I love that. Okay, tell us, first of all, you're big Star Wars fans, I'm guessing.
We are. We like Star Wars.
It's just
it's
a guess.
Obvious.
Right, really? These costumes, I mean, it really does look like you got it off the movie set.
Yeah, and that's what we tried for. You know, we're actually a local group of people that for various reasons got Star Wars costumes. Thanks to the internet, we were able to find each other. And because of that, we were able to go out, go to different events, and we try to do our best to do stuff for charity.
Okay, wait, will you tell everybody who all the characters are? We need the big furry guy. This is Wampa.
That's the Wampa.
Okay. And before we go on, I almost sat on his lap earlier. He was sitting in a chair out in our lobby. I thought he was a stuffed animal, and I almost just, like, jumped on him.
Your
not felt good.
Your costumes are incredible.
They really are.
Can you tell me,
Darth Vader.
I have to know how much these are. How much is a cost?
A lot. It, you know, it really depends on how much work we put into them, but it gets up there. But
all right, Darth Vader, Jango Fett, and a Royal Guard. These are great, great costumes. I love them. All right, and you have given so much to Toys for Tots. What made you decide to do that?
Well, we've got these great costumes, and we like to put them to use. Instead of leaving them at home in a box somewhere, we try to get out, make kids happy. This year, we were able to go out to Media Play for the Episode 2 DVD release.
Mm-hmm.
And because we did that, Media Play asked us if we'd like to donate some toys. So thanks to Dana Williams at the Fort Union Media Play, we were able to get over 500 toys to donate to Toys for Tots.
And Sergeant Bird from the Marines, I guess you can attest to that. You said they just brought in a bunch of stuff.
Correct. They donate every year, and actually the toys, I was going to bring a few with me, just kind of let the audience know what type of toys they donated, but they're gone already. They was going on Monday.
Because you're delivering them to the kids now.
Correct. We started on Monday and we'll end on Friday. The toy donation has actually been down compared to last year. So we started out on Monday doing 3 toys per child. We're down to 1 now. So.
But I bet 600 toys from these guys
really helped.
Yeah. It helped out a lot.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, you guys are wonderful.
Thank you.
Fantastic.
You look great.
Fantastic. I know these costumes they're intimidating, aren't they?
They really are.
The Wampa. I forgot what he was. He was in Empire Strikes Back. And he's when he gets his arm cut off because he goes to grab.
And he's probably sweating right
okay,
now.
Okay, not Luke.
And there's no more place to donate because is Toys for Tots over?
We're actually still taking them at the Reserve Center.
Great.
Where's the Reserve Center?
It's on Fort Douglas, 116 Pollock Road.
And so if you still want to donate,
you can.
Correct. We'll still accept them until up and through Friday.
Sergeant Bird, thank you. Everyone
you guys
from
are
Star
wonderful.
Wars, thank you.
Thanks for coming on with your great costume.
Stick around, you guys, and maybe Sizzler will feed us all. We're going to do shrimp scampi in the kitchen coming up next.